I debunk unsettling online videos for a living. I run a small but loyal channel that, among other things, focuses on debunking unsettling online videos. Usually, it is the noise that's a dead giveaway. You would not believe how many of these ghost sighting videos contain public domain noises. A quick search, and I can tell you most of the quote-unquote otherworldly noises are coming from. For videos that use slightly more sophisticated effects, such as objects moving, or the like, I have to be a bit more hands-on. I download the video in question and meticulously go through it frame by frame. I try to notice any signs of editing or effects, such as blurring or shadows. Even the best-made hoax videos stump me for only so long before I figure out their trick. All except the latest video I was working on. I was doing some research on what video to debunk next when I stumbled onto a video titled Found Footage from William B. Gray Asylum. The description said that two college-age students went missing 15 years ago at the titular asylum, and that this video was the footage from the camera recovered from the search. Strangely, this was the only video from the uploader, and their profile contained no information. Also, the video had been posted only a week ago, and I could not find any previous upload of it. Intrigued, I decided to take a look. Aside from one of them mentioning, rather dramatically, that he had been invited to check out the asylum by someone, they themselves never pointed out anything weird or creepy happening to them in the entirety of the video, which was a first for me. There were no creepy sounds or suspicious happenings in the background either, just two people rummaging through this derelict building. I honestly thought that I was either missing something or someone was yanking my chain, so I decided to go through the footage one more time before calling it quits. Again, it opened with one of the two mentioning that they had been invited to check out the asylum, but then I noticed something odd. The first time I watched the video, I saw nothing out of the ordinary. But this time, I started noticing shadows in the corner of some rooms. They did not move or do anything, but there was a noticeable darkness at random corners that was hard to miss. I wrote on my notepad whenever I noticed a shadow and the timestamp. I went through it a third time, and things got even weirder. This time, I couldn't spot the shadows in the corner, but I could see shadows in the reflection of certain mirrors as the students made their way through the asylum. I was completely freaked out. The hell? I thought to myself. This definitely required more investigation. I figured that, if this was true, there would be some record of these students going missing. A quick online search yielded no results. Thankfully, the place where this supposedly occurred was only a 2-hour drive from my home, so I decided to take a little road trip. I visited the local sheriff and asked to speak to someone in regard to a possible missing persons case. I explained the situation to the officer, and he laughed me off. He told me I'd been watching too many horror movies or something because no such thing had happened in that town. "This here is one of the safest towns in America," he said as he all but shoved me out of the door. "Don't be wasting your time with that Blair Witch Don't be wasting our time with that Blair Witch reject bullshit, alright?" Humiliated, but glad that I could get a confirmation that the video was a hoax, I made my way to the car. When I heard a hoarse voice call out behind me. "Young man," the voice said. I turned to face an older looking gentleman. "Yes?" I said. I didn't mean to pry, but I heard you talking to Sheriff Donovan about the asylum. "Well, yeah, but that's a hoax, right?" "Well, I have some things to tell you if you'd like to listen. Do you want to get some coffee? I know a place only about 5 minutes from here." I nodded and told him I would meet him there. I met the stranger at the diner and we both ordered some coffee. He introduced himself as Robert Smith, an ex-officer in the city police department. He didn't work there anymore, and the reason would be quite obvious to anyone who laid eyes on him. His body had been ravaged by cancer. His hair was thin as his frame, and he just looked so frail. He coughed quite a bit too, a hoarse, throaty kind of cough that suggested he had a permanent lump in his throat. Like I said, I heard you asking Donovan about those missing kids, he started. Yes, you see, I saw a video that was labeled as found footage from 15 years ago, and the description said that it was two college students, but you know, I couldn't find any news online, and the sheriff just laughed me off. I replied, somewhat indignantly.
Well, that's because they kept it a secret.
My eyes grew large. You're telling me that the cops silenced an entire town? How? Why? He gave me a long, hard look, as if he was debating telling me whatever he was about to say.
Why? It's simple. The college. This is a small town in the middle of buttfuck nowhere. After the asylum closed down, the biggest source of income was the college. You can't have families feeling insecure about sending their bundles of joy here. If word got out the students go missing here, and that we can't find them, well, wouldn't that just be so bad for the town?
A shocked look crossed my face. How do you know all this? I asked. He looked at me and said,
I used to work for the police force, before the cancer.
Then he leaned in and told me with some deep shame in his voice,
I was the one who covered it up. One day, my superiors brought me into a closed room and showed me the video of some dumb teenagers who'd gone poking around the ruins of the asylum. They told me to find the students or make the whole thing go away. In the end, the only option I had was to make it go away.
Anguish consumed his fragile face.
I'm sorry about what I did. I really am. But morals don't put food on the table, you know. If I let this become a scandal, it could have destroyed the whole town.
He almost sobbed.
I had to plant evidence. I helped convince those families their kids had run off.
His eyes watered.
And after that, I took up smoking to calm my nerves. I smoke so much, it's no wonder I'm like this.
I got up, put a few bills on the table and said, thank you for letting me know. And as I made to leave, he said,
Please, whatever you do, don't go messing with that place. It's taken enough already.
I walked out without looking back. I rode home in silence, mulling over everything Robin had said. So there really was something mysterious going on with the asylum. Well, like Sheriff Asshole had said, maybe I had watched too many horror movies. And so I did not plan to snoop into the asylum anymore.
Or so I thought.
Yesterday, I got an anonymous email inviting me, with a plus one, to the William B. Gray Asylum. The invitation is marked for tomorrow night. I know I shouldn't go. I know I just really shouldn't. But maybe I can get some answers. Just maybe, I can get to the bottom of this mystery.